Hello, my name is Kurt. I'm a design master at LEGO Star Wars, and I've been working on 75308 R2-D2. Well, R2-D2 is actually a bit of a fun thing for me because I've actually been revisiting the design I did for almost 10 years ago. So it was quite a challenge actually to try to reinvent the model. R2-D2 is sort of a multi-tool droid, so he has all these sort of gadgets, and there are some tools in the front, and they can be opened from the back, so you push as a push button, and then you have tools coming out. And then you have some arms up underneath, more or less in front of the model. There's a hand that can hold a tool like a minifigure hand. And then there's a data plug that he uses when he's trying to get his friends out of trouble. And up in the head, you have a small periscope you can extend. On the eye of R2-D2, I have used a shield instead of a two-module round plate just to try to differentiate it from the other sensors that are on the head of R2-D2. The way the model is functioning, when it stands up, it stands on two legs. When you do a model, you also need to lock the model so it don't fall either back or forward. So you lock the model on the 2 feet in its side. Then when you put out the middle leg, you actually lift the model up and push the body forward, and then the middle leg pops down because there's a mechanism in the side legs that pops that one down. And then at the same time, you're actually also releasing the locks down in the side legs. So it is actually very technical. We revisit the R2-D2 model just to try to see if we can design it in another way and also improve on the functions. It is a completely different one than the older version. I tried to have another direction on the build. So you have a frame and then you put plates on the side. And the head is also built up. It's sort of the same structure, but it's built up with bows instead of clean bricks. That's the biggest difference. The front of the model was actually quite funny to try to solve because I wanted to have these sort of ports in the front of the model. I wanted to see if I could remake them sort of more right to the reference, and then also trying to get the details with the blue lines on one of the sides. Try to see if I could get that better and get it in another way than usual. The new exclusive element on this set is this sign beside the plaque with the Lucasfilm's 50 years anniversary. So this is LEGO's way of celebrating that. And there's also an Easter egg. There's also a lightsaber hiding inside the head. The lightsaber is Luke Skywalker's lightsaber that's been ejected to him in the scene with the sail barge in Return of the Jedi. On the main model of R2-D2, there is no stickers, but we have, of course, the plaque, and then again, we have the sign, 50 years anniversary. I am, of course, very proud of the function, and then I'm also proud of the whole the front of the model, because that was a fun thing to build. I'm also quite happy with the solution I had in the head of adding a bit more details and adding features in the head. And so you can always try out new stuff.